So folks, today I'm going to start showing you how I work with the Artist Paint Sticks. They are the Shiva Paint Sticks. They're made by Richson Art. I've been using these for, a little while. Only about, 35 years. So you've seen the watercolors, but these are the paint sticks. And I'm going to take you over the next couple videos from start to finish on the piece. So as you see, I'm laying out the first rectangle of this piece. Now, I hold paintings in my head. This one's been rolling around in my head based on what I do at my other work. You know, unfortunately in this day and age, many artists, at least most artists, can't make it just on the sale of paintings. So I bartend as well. So this is a piece from a few days ago, maybe longer than that, from a really crowded night when a whole bunch of waiting folks came in. So I started the piece by laying in with yellow, and it's a yellow Azu paint stick cup. And I use the yellow because it will pollute the other colors the least. So this particular night was Saturday night, wedding party came in, and they were ready to party. All the more so because they were naval men. I'm already running into some trouble. I don't like where that piece is. So, first object lesson. So when I hit a problem with the original sketch, I will just, I love having the studio, I can just throw things on the floor. I will just switch the color of the sketch, and all of these incidental marks will get incorporated into the final piece. So it doesn't, this is unlike watercolor where if you paint it, it's there. This is an opaque medium, and that means I can cover mistakes, unlike, like I say, with watercolors where you've done it. You've got to like what you did or figure out how you're going to make it work. I'd be willing to start over. So the Shiva paint sticks, as all paint sticks are oil-based. They are oil paint. So I'll switch back to the yellow. I like to describe them as a dried up tube of oil paint that you simply take the tube part of the oil paint off the casing, and what you have left is intrinsically an oil stick. This painting's already going a whole lot differently than I had envisioned, which is fine. It's part of what I call letting the painting make the painting. So, let's get another guy trying to get his ruler in here. Another thing I do, so I'm drawing this guy, so I want to have him, so I can have a feeling, you know? Which, of course, makes a lot of my pieces, the body types tend to be very similar to my own, because I'm trying to figure out how the piece works. Go away, spider. No, that's not going away. Last night I had this crazy experience of a snake falling into my living room. It's a little less than, well, it was quite entertaining, a little less than amusing. That was figuring out the lip of the bar, the little move was. Now, as you notice, I didn't go all the way to the edges of the paper. I once had a painting instructor saying, telling me the first four lines of your painting were the edges of the paper, and being a bit contrary, I was like, what did you make of my first four? So, you know, let's get the bride here now. And you always think of being here a bride, but by the time I see them, most times any level of demureness is worn off. Of course, this is the modern age. Yeah, this woman's arm. Let's see if her gesture. She's behind the bartender. Now, already I'm going to play with reality, where I work. We wear black shirts, but this form being dark, would not suit. We have another person leaning in over here. That would be a woman. Cocktail left is right there, which is not using. Got her expression later. Let's get the other guy back here. Actually, he's another Navy man. And this is the bartender's arm right here. He's got a shaker tin. One of the things about also not going all the way to the edge is, when you see like this, I can break the edge a little bit. It makes the painting a little more dynamic. And then when I frame a piece, I frame it in such a way you see all of the paper, including those little thumbtack holes or pushpin holes. So it shows the history of the painting coming together. So you can see I'm trying to get my marks in. So that's generally what I want to do with this piece in terms of position, composition, etc. So I'm going to stop this one here and work on this a bit off camera. Come back with another video for you to show you some blending techniques, etc. So there you go. So get a sheet of paint sticks, and God knows where the camera is. I will post a link to where you can buy the very palette I use, and I'll talk about that as I start fixing. So thanks for taking a look at this.